7654321.
You'll never have me.
Hey everybody, this is Matt Beck from freesaloneducation.com. I want to say good morning to all of you. So what I wanted to spend a few minutes talking to you guys about this morning is social media and how it can affect salon business. I think a lot of people, I've been to a lot of conferences lately, and they go over and over about how they got famous on Instagram or how they built themselves up on Twitter and Facebook. But the reality is most people want to get their salon more successful. They don't necessarily want themselves to be the focus. So they want to earn more dollars in the salon. So the first thing that I say to salons is, if you want to get somebody's attention, then you're gonna start tagging them. So if you want local businesses in your town to start sharing your work or start working with different businesses within your area to get more customers and share customers, then you tag local businesses in your work to get them exposure, and also they'll return the favor in getting you exposure. If you want people to search and find you, that's when you use the hashtag. A hashtag is a searchable word. So just like if I want to gain the attention of hairdressers, I would put hashtag hairdresser or hashtag hair color or hashtag balayage or hashtag salon business, things like that. If I want to get the attention of people in my area, my town, then I use hashtag New Hope, Pennsylvania, hashtag hair salon. Those keywords are what people are going to search for. It's going to show up in their feed. So if people like things in New Hope and they're searching things in their town, then when they go through their feed, you're going to pop up. The next thing is content. What kind of content are you putting out on the internet? If you're just putting out mediocre work on the internet, then people aren't going to notice it. You want to put your best work out there, and you want to do it consistently, which we're going to talk about in a minute. So make sure that you put the best work that you have. If you don't love it, they're not going to love it. Don't put it out there. You want people browsing through to see what your salon has to offer. Also, we talk about consistency. You want to be consistently posting on a daily basis your work. Gather up pictures throughout the day, save them so that every day you're putting something out that is getting your work shown and putting it out there for people to see it. The thing about the internet is it's moving so fast. So you put out a picture and an hour later, everyone's forgot about you and they're looking at somebody else's picture. So my goal is always to put out three things a day, because I get something in the morning, the afternoon, and the evening, and that way people never forget. The internet is all about not being forgotten. One quick little story on that, I have a stylist who does a balayage video. Our videos, we get 1 million views a month on YouTube for our step-by-step hair videos. We've done over 600 videos. I had a stylist who did a balayage video. He was so excited. The first day he got 2,000 views, and then he came up to me and he's like, I'm so excited, I got 2,000 views. And I just said to him, are you already focused on your next video? Because people are already forgetting about it. Even though you got 2,000 views, that's great, but now they've already moved on to the next balayage video or the next thing. So you wanna make sure you're focused on consistently creating content so you're never forgotten. One last thing, I grew my Instagram from 5,000 followers to 50,000 followers in the last 4 months because I started focusing on video. Video is the biggest thing. That's why I'm coming to you guys live on a video this morning. Video is the way that we're gonna communicate. It's the thing that people look at. It's the biggest thing on Instagram, creating a 1 minute how-to video. So if your stylist create these videos showcasing products, showcasing how to do different styles. People get so afraid of putting their art out there, but the art is what's gonna build people, it's gonna bring people in. So they shouldn't be afraid of creating education for their customers. That's what it's all about. So you don't have to be famous on Instagram. You don't have to be famous on Facebook or YouTube. You want to be famous in your town. And the way you're going to do that is hashtag the right things, create the content consistently, and just keep posting so that you're never forgotten. Thank you guys so much for checking out this video. Go to freesaloneducation.com. We have over 600 step-by-step videos that are very detailed. Thanks.